Support for the Alaska Live series of live music and conversation on KUAC is made possible by a grant from Design Alaska. Design Alaska, strengthening the community through support of the arts. Good evening. I'm your Alaska Live host. I'm Lori Neufeld. Special treat tonight here at the studios. We have Sarah Mitchell and friends, including on this first song, her mom, Gianna Trogejo. That's no. Could you introduce yourself so I don't screw up your name one more time?
Trogejo.
Trogejo. And doing music of Jim Bell. How are we going to get this thing started, Sarah?
Well, the first song we're going to do for you is called Love Takes Its Toll, and it's a duet between a younger woman and an older woman. So here we are, mother and daughter.
Perfect.
And it was featured in a show called Good as Gold in the 80s. Nothing better than mother-daughter harmonies, and that was gorgeous, you guys. Thank you. Jim really wrote very well for women. for the female voice.
Indeed. And so Jim Bell, he wrote that back in the 80s for the Palace Theater. Mm-hmm. And Jana, were you singing in the 80s at the Palace?
Yeah, I was in that first year that Rick Winter, when he took over the Palace Theater. And it was an hour-long show, and there was a whole storyline going through it, you know. It was a lot of fun.
So it wasn't just vignettes, there were whole storylines.
It was a little bit vignettes, yeah. But more of a storyline. You know, Golden's Grocery was in it, and it was really fun. Neat. Yeah.
Are you in it these days?
No. We let the younger girls do that.
We promoted the show as Palace Saloon and Theater Past and Present Players.
There you go.
You're of the past, and that you remember when that show tune was written.
Oh yes, I do. Yes,
mm-hmm. And I do want to mention we'll find pretty soon that. You know, pretty much every Fairbanks performer has been through the Palace, every theater performer. And some of the women who sang on that song traditionally. So when I was three listening to it, it was Julie Inkford Jones and Julie Rafferty.
Right.
So they're just a couple
of
the ladies.
So Sarah was three when she first saw this show.
And here she is organizing the Alaska Live on KUAC for the Jim Bell Music Tonight. Come a long way and singing so beautifully. Okay, what's next on the set list?
Next, we have a song called Lady Aurora, also known as Aurora Borealis. And this is a song from a little earlier when the Palace was owned by Millie Link and Bigfoot, John Bigfoot Link. Millie was known as Miss Millie, the Alabama Filly. And she was a heavily featured performer in those days. This is one of the pieces that Jim and Millie would do together.
Like swirling pools of magic light, the colors swim and whirl at night, creating lovely patterns, lovely patterns in the sky.
Lady Aurora, such a cleverly written song, because is it about the lady of the night or is it about the lights of the night?
I don't know, Lori. It's a mystery.
Yeah, I know. And that's such a good turn of phrase with how Jim Bell wrote that mysterious way of talking about the Aurora and the woman.
And one part of the presentation back in the day was Mo Holland, who's a very well-known dancer in town. She would come out with blue and green scarves and be dancing in the middle of that number. So added quite a flair.
Summer visitors don't necessarily get to experience the Aurora because it's too light into the night. And so you kind of have to be more of a winter visitor to experience that. And so this is the way the summer visitors that go to the Palace Theater Show get to experience the Aurora.
Exactly. Yes. And I think one thing I love about Jim's music is it's very rooted in a time and place. So it's uniquely Alaskan, and it speaks to that time period when everybody was flocking here. So that's what I like about them.
Everybody was flocking here because of the gold rush, and so that's it's a very good time and place piece, yeah. What's up next?
So next, my friend Kit Cleworth has joined me, and he's going to be playing piano for the rest of the show, and we're going to do a number called Man in the Moon, which is from also the Millie Link days, and this song was really fun. In the middle dance interlude, Abby Johnson would come out with a big moon headdress. So that was that was exciting. So this one's called Man in the Moon.
The boys you know, they come and go. They leave you with a token. But roses wilt and candy melts, and promises are broken. Yes, true heart is a rarity. When the clock strikes two, now I'm alone and he's at home. So what's a girl to do? Another night just slipped away with all my dreams uncourted. Yet still it seems when moonlight beams, I'll not go unescorted. I'm walking home with the man in the moon. He'll keep an eye on me. He'll shine his light right to my door. He'll kiss my cheek 5 nights a week and never ask for more. And that's why I'm walking home with the man in the moon. He'll be my boa tonight. Whether he's waxing or waiting, and even when it's raining, I'm walking home with the man in the moon. Walking home with the man in the moon. He'll be so kind to me. We'll walk beneath a curtain of stars. Each night I'll dream and ride his beam to Jupiter and Mars. And that's why I'm walking home with the man in the moon. Well, we've got a standing date. Oh, whether he's waxing or waning, and even when it's raining, I'm walking home with the man.
Really wonderful.
Thank you. It's a sweet little number.
That's a sweet little number for sure. So we've been mentioning the Palace Theater and the Palace Theater and Saloon Show, but we haven't really mentioned, for those people who've never visited Alaska or Fairbanks, you know, what this is all about, where it is, when it's going on. And so tell us a little bit about that, Sarah.
So the Palace Theater does shows 7 nights a week throughout the summer, and we have all kinds of folks coming from all over. It's called the Golden Heart Review, and all the music in the show was composed by Jim. And there's also really funny sketches. It goes through dog mushing and other Alaskan topics.
And we're costuming.
Right, costuming. Yes. And it's down at Pioneer Park, which those of us who have been here for a long time still call Alaskaland, stubbornly. But we're at Pioneer Park.
Cool.
So please come see us. We love it when locals come because they're rowdy.
That's right. And you don't have to have an excuse like you have family in town. You can just have it as date night or a group of you get together and go out to the Palace Theater, because you can see this show over and over and it's always new and fresh and fun because you have so much music to choose from. Jim Bell was a prolific writer.
Yes, he composed hundreds of songs, too many to count, really. But there's some really nice ones in the palace.
And those are all originals written for the palace theater show, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
they are.
Amazing. Well, you've got more singers in here, so let's move on to them, too.
I'm going to bring out two of my favorite gentlemen. First of all, we have Mr. Steve Mitchell, and then we have Mr. Bruce Hansen.
Mitchell, that sounds familiar, yeah, Sarah Mitchell.
Steve Mitchell is my father, and Bruce Hansen and I are doing the Palace Show currently this summer, and we have a lot of fun doing it. And they are going to do a song called Cabin Fever Blues. It's a very dignified song. For those of you in the radio audience, they're wearing giant fur hats right now.
And we need to bring you out of the inky shadows.
Come on over here. And so they're going to do a song called Cabin Fever Blues, which I'm told by Marlene, Jim, his wife, wrote this song in about 15 to 20 minutes. He went out to his studio and came back inside with this song ready to go. And this is going to show, I think it's safe to say, a different side of Jim Bell.
When the winter sun goes down, Okie's hauling ass out of town. Cabin fever setting in for real. Hawk comes whistling through the trees. Forgot to buy the antifreeze. Been a week at least since my last home-cooked meal. Weather strippings on the door, insulation's on the floor, and the cat's been using his litter box again instead of going outside. And the cat's been using his litter box again. Do whack a 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 do do do. Making airplanes out of the bills, drinking wine to fight the chills. Wore my bunny boots to bed again last night. Dug my parka out of the trunk, put it on and ooh, it stunk. So I took it back off and shivered just for spite. But northern lights just make me dizzy, but the doc says I gotta keep busy. And the cat's been using his litter box again instead of going outside. Oh, the cat's been using his litter box again. I find no humor whatsoever in this godforsaken weather when the cat starts using his litter box again instead of going outside. Oh, the cat's been using his litter box again. Do wackadoo, wackadoo.
Our Cabin Fever boys, Bruce and Steve, were wearing their fur hats for that Cabin Fever song. You got to get into the mood. And
absolutely.
With the...
It doesn't work without the hat.
Oh, that was a fun song. Did you sing that on the palace stage
actually,
in the past, Steve?
That was one song that was written for a show at the Fairbanks Inn, which was on South Cushman, in the off-season. And my wife, Gianna, and Jim, and his wife, Marlene, Jim put together this little four-person show, and we did that in the fall of, I believe, 1978. And then that song went on to be included in future Palace shows and at the Malamute Nester.
Right. Well, that was a much funnier version of you than we saw this last time you were on stage with Cat on a Hot Tin Roof.
He was not a nice guy.
No. I'm so glad to see this part of Steve Mitchell this time.
A man of many faces.
Yes. Yes. And we've seen you on the Fairbanks Shakespeare Theater stage, Fairbanks Drama Association, and at the Palace Theater. So this is great. Sarah, this is... I really want to ask you about the Rasmussen grant you got. Can we talk a little bit
Sure.
about this? It was just announced, I noticed.
It was just announced 2 days ago. I'm just thrilled to be a recipient of their individual artist award. They gave out somewhere in the 20s project grants. And with this project award, I'm going to be able to record an album of Jim's music. So I'm just so grateful because it's been something I've wanted to do ever since he passed away in 2007. And now this organization is giving me the resources to make it happen. So
that's great.
Really
so
exciting.
Has there been a compilation of his music in recording so far, or will this be the first?
The track we heard of Smoker is from an album they called Songs from the Palace, and I'm not sure where it was recorded, but that was in the early 90s. Okay. But there are many songs that have never been formally recorded.
Yeah, I mean, you said he has, you know, over 100, and so you have a lot to choose from. Have you started to choose?
I have. That's going to be the hardest part because it's like, you know, you don't want to play favorites, choosing between babies, and different people like different songs. And yeah, so it'll be quite a project. But Kit has been helping me enormously getting them all digitized and into music software so we can kind of use them a lot more nimbly.
Well, congratulations. Getting a Rasmussen grant is one of those dreams I know a lot of people have. And it is a lot of work to put together. The legwork beforehand, before you even find out that you got it, is quite extensive.
It was, yes.
So congratulations on all your hard work. It's paying off. And we really look forward to seeing what comes of this and the music getting,
Thank you. You
know, like you say, on record, and so people can have a piece of that history to listen to whenever they want to.
Yes. Yeah. And I'm looking forward to involving as many folks as I can who have, you know, passed through the palace or the Malamute or where have you, who encountered Jim. Many people were touched by him.
Okay, so what do we have next from the set list?
So I've got my dad here, and we're going to do something a little different. So this piece, so we want to show what a hard worker Jim was and how he ran rehearsals. He took rehearsals very seriously. He was, you know, kind of a cruise director, getting everybody where they needed to be and when. And one of the biggest events of the year would be the Golden Days Parade. So I'll let my dad set that up a little bit more.
Okay. Every year for the Golden Days Parade, Jim would borrow Hilda the Hay Wagon from Nilo Kaponen on Chena Ridge. And this would be a big event for the whole palace crew. And now I just want to say, I don't want to say Jim was a control freak, but I will say Jim covered every aspect of what could possibly go wrong. And it just so happened that I must have ripped this off the wall of the palace 25, 30 years ago. And it's called Golden Days Instructions. It's 4 pages long. All caps, red underlining, and I'm just going to be able to read a few segments of it, but it'll just give you an idea of how thorough and meticulous Jim was as the head bongo in charge. Golden Days Instructions. Thursday afternoon, Bluebell and Miss Millie fetch Hilda the hay wagon from her home on the ridge. Friday noon, work party at 532 2nd Street, Grail. And then he's got directions. Need men with tools other than your own personal one. Realize some men have normal jobs 8 to 5, so at this point, I'm hoping for Don DeWitt, Steve Mitchell, Larry, Jim Kay, Jim Snyder. Others are welcome to check with us later in the afternoon to see how we're doing. But since I've saved all the parts of Hilda's superstructure, we should be able to slam it together in a couple of hours. Need cuties and future cuties for painting Hilda's red parts redder, blowing up balloons, making pom-poms, etc. Friday evening, immediately after work. Need help loading Bluebell's van with assorted props, etc. from Palace. Need Bigfoot and Millie to arrange opening the back gate for 20 minutes. Saturday morning, very early. The parade this early has been scheduled an hour earlier than last year, making it a bit more difficult for us than before. Robin, who will be attending the Thursday night meeting, will find out what is the latest possible time for us to be in line at Fort Wainwright. This means everyone who intends to ride on the float must be at Bluebell's no later than 8:15. The reason for this is, due to the unpredictable weather conditions, we must put nothing paper on the float until Saturday morning prior to departure. This means all the signs, all the balloons, all pom-poms, decor, etc., goes on Hilda in about a half an hour. Here is where we need everyone's absolute cooperation. Follow these rules. Arrive in costume, makeup, etc. Girls, this means everything but feathers and heels, perhaps. Do not come in jeans with no hair done, no makeup. You will not have time to do all this when you get here. Do not stand around BSing. Put yourself to work. Bluebell will assign materials and tasks. Work quietly and finish what you start, then ask for something more. All furniture, piano, sound system, etc. must be on board in this scant amount of time. Men, get someone to help you with a costume. Cowboy hats, cowboy boots, checkered shirts, bandanas, etc. are a good way to go if you're stuck. Do not expect someone else to be costumed when you arrive. Please bring tools. If you're going to be hungry, bring your own sandwich, donuts, or whatever. No coffee will be available. Bring your own if you must. Don't be late, assuming that everyone else will take up the slack for you. We need a lot of organized labor, so be on time. If there is some reason you cannot make this early hour, please clear with Millie or Bluebell beforehand. Okay, and I'll skip along here to go wee-wee before we leave the compound. No more than 4 or 5 people on Hilda's roof area at one time. Spread yourselves around the entire float area. Balance the sides evenly as you would a small boat. Do not just sit and look stupid. We have a reputation for this liveliest float in this parade, and we'd like to keep it that way. We want singing, shouting, clapping, waving, screaming, dancing, etc. Look alive, even if you're not. Okay, and then this is my favorite instruction on the fragment of page 2 that I have. Try not to get wasted Friday night. There is nothing worse than doing the parade with a fierce hangover. And that's just a sample of Jim Bell's Golden Days instructions.
He really did write those. I can see that they're an old laminated copy, and it's red underlined everywhere. It's all in caps, and it is very specific about, you know, including go wee-wee beforehand.
And the funny thing about this is Jim did not intend this to be funny. He's dead serious about this. He's just trying to keep his minions under control.
Yeah.
And cover every angle. And like he's got Jim Snyder is our chauffeur and in charge of vehicle maintenance. I would suggest water for the radiator. And it just goes on and on.
Very specific. You know, and Sarah, your daughter, Sarah Mitchell, is she's taking after Jim in some ways. She's got it all together and organized. I tell you, working with her was a dream, setting this Alaska Live up, because she communicated well. She got everybody here at a certain time, and there was no questions about, you know, how this was all going to go. And so I think she learned from the best.
She is terrific, and I think her godfather, Jim, must have helped along the way. I know he did.
Yeah, Sarah, that speaking of Jim as your godfather, Jim Bell was your godfather. That's who your parents chose to be your godfather. So he had an influence in all of your life.
Yes, he was. You're probably getting the idea that my childhood was pretty interesting. And the Bell household was just down the street from ours. And Jim and Marlene were at my parents' wedding. And they were just really special, a really special part of our lives. And he would show up to my birthday parties in full costume as Bumbershoot the Clown. And it never struck me that that was odd or, you know, right? Unusual until I grew up.
That was the way it should be.
Right.
You look back at pictures now and you're like, wow. And people didn't even have to pay him to show up like that.
Right?
You know, he did not have to be hired. He was a part of the show.
It's
it
serious.
Was your birthday.
All right. Well, thanks so much, Dad.
Oh, that was hilarious to have those. And those were not meant to be funny. That was the funny part about that. It was just seriously, this is what you need to do.
Yeah.
And please do not get wasted the night before, because there's nothing worse than riding on the float hungover, right?
We've all been there.
It's just such good suggestions, and they weren't really suggestions, they were commandments. Mm-hmm. What's next?
Well, next I'm going to do another number with Kit. So we'll thank Dad, and thank you so much. And then, so Kit and I are going to do a song that I know I shouldn't play favorites, but right now it's my favorite. It's called Stage Door Johnny, and it's another piece that he used to perform with Millie in the early 80s, and it's another sort of Millie the showgirl going home and what's going to happen on her way home from the show. Johnny, stage door, Johnny, Johnny, stage door, Johnny. Oh, it's so nice to know someone's waiting in the wings. It's one of those things that's nice to know. It's also twice as handy if it happens he's a dandy who's willing to wait, killing some time, waiting to walk you home from the show. I've got a date to do an encore with my sweetheart at the stage door with the lights turned way down low. I just can't wait to do an encore with my sweetheart at the stage door. It's a private show. Somehow I'll let him know when they ring down the curtain. I'm certain which way my heart is gonna go. 'Cause it's my fate to do an encore with my sweetheart at the stage door, who's waiting to walk me home from the show. The dozens of roses or even the sparkling champagne. It's not the big black umbrella he packs when it looks like rain. I can do without London, Paris, Rome, or Barcelona, Spain, if he's willing to wait.
I'm willing to wait.
Killing some time.
I'm killing some time.
Waiting to walk me home from the show. He swears I look 16. I can manage without top billing here and still remain serene, because you can't always find at the stage door the right kind of guy for an encore who's willing to walk you home.
Willing to walk you home.
I said he's willing to walk me home from the show.
Oh, how fun.
Fun. And yeah, you could just picture her in her show garb. Yeah. Just walking through this Alaskaland Gold Rush town.
Right, because Pioneer Park, does look like an old Gold Rush town. They've done such a good job there. And you just wander around in the winter or in the summer. You can wander around there, and that's where the Palace Theater is too. And so it's a great setting. It puts you in the mood as you're walking to the Palace Theater of what you're going to experience there with the song and dance.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay, what's next? Are you ready to, your vocal cords are all warmed up.
Getting there, yeah. Well, yeah, and one other thing I'll say is I do have a Facebook page for the project, which is called Jim Bell Music. So if you haven't liked that yet, please go out there. It's Facebook, Jim Bell Music. And there's fun photos,
really
videos.
Fun.
Lots of people are having fun remembering Jim and those golden days.
Yeah, and there's a lot of people here in town that remember going to the Palace show back in the 80s. And it was called the Golden Heart Review now, right? Mm-hmm. And it was called...
They didn't start doing those hour-long shows until that first Good as Gold, I believe. So back in when Millie and John Link owned it, they would do different shows. There was one called Red Hot Nights, and there would just be different productions that Jim would put on. But it was a much more local scene at the time, and people really enjoyed going there every
mm-hmm.
night.
Mm-hmm. And, boy, locals can enjoy it nowadays, too, because there's something for everyone. I mean, whether you know Fairbanks like the back of your hand or you're just visiting for a night, this show is really a fun one with great music and great performers. Yeah.
And it's fun, too, because it's double cast, so you can see different casts.
Oh,
and,
yeah.
You know, if you do the show with one person and then the next day you do it with a different person, mm-hmm. it changes it up a little bit. So
cool.
That's fun for us.
Yeah. All right.
All right. So next, this is going to be quite a tone switch. This song, if my dad were still here in the room, he would say, it's a million-dollar song waiting to be heard. This piece was composed by Jim for his master's thesis, and it was part of a musical. So it's kind of more more musical theater-y, less like the cabaret show tune-y thing.
Did he do his master's thesis here at UAF?
At UAF, he did. Mm-hmm. And so this song is called Hello Love, or This Dear Old Friend of Mine.
I can tell you grew up singing, and you grew up singing this music and witnessing your parents sing this music, and it's just really in your blood as a family. That just had so much emotion to it.
And, thank you.
Is that one of those that you're trying to include in the recording?
Definitely. Mm-hmm. I think that's one of the songs that didn't, you know, it was created for a master's thesis, so it didn't really get performed as much. My mom used to sing it a lot, and Jane Haycraft used to sing it. But it's definitely one that I want to work on. And like you said, I quite literally heard the music in the womb. And so it just kind of has always stuck with me. It's really important to me.
Yeah. You're never too young or too old to enjoy tunes that have such a sense of place. And it's really great. All right. It's another duet with, what do we, you have more singers in here now.
I do. Let's introduce them. Mm-hmm. So to my left right now is Adele States.
Hello.
Yay. Hello. And Adele and I do the Palace Show together. She's called Woman One. I'm called Woman Two.
Can I just call you that from rest of the show? Great.
And this scene is where we encounter each other. At the laundromat, or, you know, we're, I guess it's not a laundromat at the time, the bathhouse. And we're like washing our laundry in the tubs. And I am a lady of the night, as it were. So I'm from the red light district. And Adele is more prim and proper and put together. And we're sort of colliding as women in the north together.
Respectable women work both night and day, working day and night in a most respectable way, never letting down, never letting down, never letting down, never ever letting go, never saying no, never saying it's impossible, never letting spirits get low, never giving up, never giving in, never letting down, never ever letting go. Oh, if anything, we're respectable.
In between shovels of mud and hauling water and wood and sacks of beans and
fighting fires just like a man, a woman standing alongside men, in between cleaning up the mess they've made and starting to build all over again. We steal try to steal away for a little while. Just enough time to get away from it all, to recall for a moment who we really are. Just enough time for a couple deep breaths and a hurried prayer for the grace to accept. To accept the way things are.
A lovely duet, Adele and Sarah. Adele, where did you come from? You're on the scene and with a gorgeous voice.
Thank you. I'm here from Fairbanks. I was born and raised in town.
Really? Oh. And did you go to UAF in the music department?
I was in the choir at UAF for 1 year. I'm not in the department. I'm not enrolled at UAF right now. But I was for a year, taking a break now for work.
She was in Les Miserables last year. She was great.
That's right.
Uh-huh. I heard great things about that show, and you're a big part of that. Wow, you have just a lovely voice. And so are you part of the Palace Theater show this summer?
I am. This is my third summer now at the Palace Theater as Woman One. It's a lot of fun.
You don't even get a character name.
She does get to play E.T. Barnett's wife for a little bit.
Oh, good.
Who's also not having a good time getting stuck in the Chena River.
No. And Luscious Louise as a can-can girl at one point.
She gets to have some fun.
Good.
Her
yes.
Out of it.
Excellent. And we've got more singers here.
Yes, we have two more songs. So we're going to bring some gentlemen over here. So we have Bruce Hansen, live Bruce Hansen, instead of the audio clip. And then we also have Nathan Jones. And just to stick with the theme, Nathan Jones plays Man 1, and Bruce plays Man 2 in the show. So together, the four of us make up the cast plus the piano player.
Malcolm, welcome Man 1, Man 2, Woman 1, Woman 2.
Thank you. Great to be here. So this next song we do as a tribute to Jim Bell in the Golden Heart Review. And this song is called Ghosts of the Gold Rush, and it was part of that show, Fortune's Tales of the Gold Rush, that we did, I think, in 97.
Makes such a nice choir.
Well, thank you.
Yeah.
All right. And our last number has to come to an end. There's many more Jim Bell songs, but this is all we have today.
Right. We don't have time for all 100 of them, but they have such a variety that I think, you know, someday we can do the Jim Bell marathon.
There you go.
Maybe just not on Alaska Live, but right. This has to happen somewhere.
Coffee will not be provided, though. You have to bring your own.
Right. You must bring your own sandwich and your own coffee.
So this next song is called It's Lovely Here. I adore this song. It's been closing the Golden Heart Review for years, and so many wonderful female singers have sung this piece. And it's the end of the show, how we all kind of send people off and get them feeling good about Alaska. So today Adele is going to sing it, and then we'll join her at the end.
What a perfect conclusion to the Alaska Live featuring Sarah Mitchell and the music of Jim Bell. Sarah Mitchell and friends.
It's really
couldn't agree more. It is lovely here, and the sounds of you make it even more lovely. Thank you, Sarah, for bringing in all the Palace players from the past and present here to be on Alaska Live. It was really wonderful hearing the music of Jim Bell tonight.
Thank you so much, Lori. It was a great experience. Thanks for having us.
You don't have to worry about me.
You can find links to more episodes of Alaska Live TV and download audio podcasts of the Alaska Live radio show online at KUAC.org. Support for the Alaska Live series of live music and conversation on KUAC is made possible by a grant from Design Alaska. Design Alaska, strengthening the community through support of the arts.